Thank you. such numbers this evening. We are very flattered and very happy to see you all here. And there are still a few empty seats. If people coming in would like to sit, this is a good time to do it. I guess maybe not. I'm not going to say much about the music because there are quite a few tedious program notes that I wrote in the concert program. But I will talk a little bit about the ensemble. This is our 36th year. The ensemble was founded in 1977 here at the Colorado College, and by yours truly. And the ensemble is old enough now to be the grandparents of the kids who are in the ensemble here. And that includes me, of course. We will be taking this program next week, starting Wednesday, to the Midwest and then to London and to a couple of concerts in Italy and also in Malta. And so we're very privileged to be a traveling student ensemble playing concerts in locales like that. And I think we'll have a lot of fun. We will work very hard as well. We hope you enjoy this evening's program, and I think we will just go ahead and play the second piece in our program, which is Aurora Ficta. I should warn you that it's not quite as melodious as the first one, and you may not have thought that was very melodious, of course, but this is a piece representing, in some way, my response to the phenomenon of false dawn, which is an astrological event that happens occasionally in the dawn, before the dawn, before the sun rises. And there is a little note about there if you're interested in reading what the NASA folks think about this. But this is just a sort of musical representation, I guess, perhaps in some ways, of the false dawn. Thank you.
Thank you.
trying to go paperless at this ensemble, but it didn't quite work. In 1977, when this ensemble came into being for the first time, we could make long notes and short ones. We used nylon fish line, which we still use, and you can probably recognize that in the piano. Rosin, so that it gripped the string of the piano, the strings of the piano, and make long, sustained notes. And we also had small tools, which we call rigid bows, which are, in fact, either popsicle sticks or compass compressors, depending on how we produce them. And they have either nylon fish line on them or, in some cases, horsehair, as you would find in a violin bow. And those are rosin, and they just go straight up and down against the string and make short staccato notes. As you can probably tell from what we're playing this evening, we've developed a lot more techniques along the way. And I must say, it's been a communal enterprise all along. So many students have contributed so many ideas, about 95% of them really good ideas, about how we could do something different or how we could make a different sound quality in the piano. And we're still exploring. The paper bows are a relatively recent innovation, I guess you wanted to call it that, which creates obviously a very different sound since we're running it under the steel frame of the piano, the various parts of the steel frame, which is called the harp. And so there's no string giving any pitch or any kind of melodic note or anything. It's just a sound. And so we're looking for more and more of those all of the time. And one of the sounds that we have introduced to the ensemble is vocal music, vocal sound, human voice. I have, in the last decade, composed two large song cycles for a soprano soloist, with the bowed piano being the orchestra, the accompaniment for the singing. And these have been performed and recorded and toured worldwide by the ensemble and by Victoria Hansen, the well-known soprano in Colorado Springs, who's on faculty also at Colorado College. And so the next piece will involve her singing, not words, but simply notes, simply a melody. And the title of the piece is called Vocalese. And so I would like for you to welcome Victoria Hansen.
Thank you.
1997, I had the privilege of working with an ensemble of students in Estonia, in the capital, Tallinn. These were all students, undergraduate and graduate students in music at the State Academy for Music in Tallinn. And I wrote this piece for them. They had never played a bowed piano, but they learned really fast. We spent a week on the techniques and rehearsing, and then we did a little mini tour in the three Baltic countries with that group. And then a few years later, we were fortunate enough to have the Colorado College as a guest ensemble, and we put two big pianos together with 20 players, 40 hands, and we made a lot of racket, and it was really a lot of fun. And so this. The various movements of this, there are five short movements of this piece called Baltic Sketches. Each one is dedicated to one of my Estonian friends from that time. And so I guess that's all I'll say, and we'll just play the piece. Thank you. As probably almost everyone here knows, it was a very stewardship and generosity in the community. People opened their homes to those who had lost theirs. The Philharmonic they gave a benefit concert, which I think had something like 3,000 people attending, maybe even more than that. There was just a great overwhelming sense of community. And I think that probably some of you here have been very closely involved in that dimension of our community. At any rate, the piece starts slowly and quietly and attempts to depict some kind of inflagration in the middle part of it, and then comes to a close, as I guess all things do, even that fire. It's not a lengthy piece, it's quite a short piece. I felt also, rather than in this piece, rather than commemorating all of the heroic firefighters who put the fire out, who chanced their lives for other people, and all of the citizens of the community who reached out to anybody that they could help. And that's one of the main themes of this piece. Another theme, however, I thought would be appropriate to also recognize the Ute peoples who have been indigenous to the area of Waldo Canyon and Ute Pass, which of course is named after the Ute people. And I wanted to sort of include some sense of what they may have gone through a few thousand years before white settlers came to this part of the continent. They had their own struggles, but also their own understanding of fire, and knew how to use it, and knew how to cultivate and how to live with fire. So along that theme, I thought it would be an important thing to incorporate some music which may remind us of and perhaps celebrate the Ute people. Most of the Ute people moved were moved to Utah long ago, but my way of acknowledging that ancient tie with the modern fire that we all experience was to build a structure in which some improvised solos could be performed on Native American flutes. Soraya Rano, who's a member of the ensemble, is an expert at these instruments, and so she will be playing solos on three different Native American flutes, we hope that that will add an extra dimension to this piece. Afternoon of the Fire.
Thank you.
setting of poetry of Garcia Lorca, and it is part of a long poem called Poem of the Deep Song, and it comes directly from the flamenco tradition of southern Spain. And this is part, again, of a larger song cycle. And we will ask Victoria Hansen back to the stage to sing this last piece. Changing the spark plug between every piece. It has different devices that we have to take off and